How old a woman are you?
Girl, yeah. 13.
13, so you're just a kid then. You're just really a kid.
Sure.
Yeah. Was this like your first big movie, this Robert Redford deal?
This was like the largest part that I've ever had, other than I did an independent film called Manny and Lowe, and I played Manny, so.
Yeah. So you've been doing this a while then?
Yeah. I guess, you know, in Scarlet Years, it's a while.
In Scarlet Years, meaning, sure, it eats up a huge percentage of your life,
right.
But you're only 13, so what are we talking about, really, then? Huh?
I've been doing it for about 5 years.
How did you get started? Did your folks help you get started? Did you always want to be an actress? What did you know?
I've always wanted to be an actress. I mean, ever since I can remember. I mean, I remember when I was 3 telling my mom that I had a fire in my brain to act, and, you know, she must have thought I was crazy or something.
Yeah.
But she said, you know, wait until you get older.
Yeah.
And so,
I remember when I was 3, I told my mom, there's something wrong in my diapers. That's a whole different deal, though. Do you have a big family?
A pretty big family. I have 3 other siblings and my 2 parents.
Are they older, younger?
I have a twin brother. Mm-hmm. I have an older brother and older sister.
Right. And are they also interested in acting?
Nobody in my family is,
really?
Actually. I was the first one.
Now, when you're like this, when you're just still a kid and you're in school and you have friends and you have family, how do they react to the fact that you're like a big shot actor? How does that go? Is that a problem for you or for them?
Well, I mean, my friends have been pretty good about it, and they've always really encouraged me to just go for it.
Well, that's nice. So you find them to be very supporting and nurturing.
Yeah.
Well, that's good, because a lot of times, you know, they can be, kids especially can be petty, and you don't want that. That's not fun for anybody.
They've been pretty good about it.
Well, good. That probably says something lovely about you. It's probably because you're a nice, decent person that they behave
in
kind.
Well, that's debatable, but, you know.
And did you ride horses and stuff?
I had never really ridden horses before. I mean, I actually told them. I felt bad about it afterwards.
You lied that you were an accomplished equestrian?
Well, no, I didn't say. I didn't use those words exactly.
Yeah.
But, you know, Bob Redford said, have you ever been on a horse before?
Uh-huh.
And I said, yes, I've been on a horse before. They may have been plastic, you know. But, you know, I didn't tell him that. I just said I'd been on a horse before. I took him literally.
Yeah.
And so, when I got the part and we started filming, the Wranglers called the casting director. My casting director called my agent and was like screaming on the phone. She doesn't know what she's doing.
Oh, yeah.
We thought she knew it arrived. She's like, no, she told you she'd been on a horse before.
Exactly. Yeah.
Did you
finally take to it all right? What is the trick? You just have to be comfortable on the animal.
Yeah, I mean, I think after a few lessons I was more comfortable and confident with what I was doing. You know, at first I was kinda like,
And you called Robert Redford Bob. Now, is that all right to be calling him Bob?
Well, I don't really call him Bob.
Yeah, what did you call him?
I call him Bowie.
Called him Bowie.
Yeah, he didn't really like it at first, but after a while he got used to it.
He got used to being called Bowie.
Yeah,
and why exactly was Bowie the name of choice?
Well, I think I didn't like to call him Bob.
Yeah.
You know, it's not that I don't like the name Bob. All you Bobs out there, you know, don't be offended. But I think that I felt like Bob sounded too formal and too kind of like the people that thought it was cool to know him would call him Bob,
Bob. First of all, he's too old to be called Bob.
Well, come on.
You could call him Robert, you could call him Mr. Redford. I don't know about this Bowie thing. That's between you you and Bob. But the fact that the guy is in his late 70s means you're not calling him Bob. You know what I'm saying?